another edition of All American Wrestling. I'm Lord Alfred Hayes, standing in for your usual host, Vince McMahon. I would like to tell you something about our program this week, but you have just been watching a part of our feature match with the fabulous Moolah against Wendy Richter. Be sure you don't miss this match. We're going to show it in its entirety, and what a humdinger it was as well. Apart from that match, we have the most charismatic masked wrestler here, Mills Mascaris. Mills Mascaris is going to hold you absolutely spellbound in your seats. And then we have a very, very important match, a most intriguing and interesting match, with Mr. Wonderful himself, Paul Orndorff, and he is going against the Italian Salvatore Bellomo. And as if that isn't enough, we're still going to have more for you, including Cowboy Bob Orton. Be sure you stay with us.
World Wrestling Federation continues on tour on Wednesday night, August 1 in Ogdensburg, New York, a special World Wrestling Federation fundraiser. Also in Utica, New York at the War Memorial Auditorium on Wednesday night, August 1. Plus, a special World Wrestling Federation extravaganza in Binghamton, New York on Thursday night, August the 2nd, as well as Watertown, New York, also Thursday night, August 2. Baltimore, Maryland, the setting, Friday night, August 3 at the Baltimore Civic Center for a World Wrestling Federation spectacular. Plus, Saturday night, August 4, Boston, the Boston Garden, the setting for an unbelievable spectacular. Philadelphia, the Philadelphia Spectrum. Saturday night, August 4, World Wrestling Federation action headed your way. Continuing on into New Haven, Connecticut on Sunday night, August 5 at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Notwithstanding, Richmond, Virginia on Tuesday night, August 7, and Winston-Salem, North Carolina, Wednesday night, August 8. Tremendous World Wrestling Federation spectaculars headed your way.
His opponent, now entering the ring area, from Florida, weighing 262 pounds, Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff.
Well, indeed, Mr. Wonderful to make his way to the ring, and right away, this capacity crowd on his case. Many of them shouting Paula, a phrase Tony Garea that Mr. Orndorff does not like at all.
He gets furiated when he sees those signs up and when he hears those people yelling out Paula. And there's going to be a lot of Paula here this week and a lot of signs up.
Well, the roar of the crowd can mean only one thing. Mr. Orndorff is making his way, yes. There, this capacity crowd clearing the path for Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Look at him. You talk about arrogance. This man exudes arrogance.
Listen to that crowd. Paula, Paula.
Yes, indeed. Mr. Orndorff's arrogance is certainly not appreciated by this capacity crowd. Preparing for the matchup with Mr. Wonderful.
Also, Paul Orndorff, a great all-round athlete. College football player, just fantastic athlete. And look at the body on him.
Yes, indeed.
You don't get that drinking beer and eating crackers watching TV. You have to be in the gym working out and sweating.
Orndorff now, I would suspect, would have problems, maybe a lot of problems, in figuring out the skills of Salvatore Bellomo, who has a very European type tactic now locked up. Orndorff, obviously the stronger of the two. It may not mean anything. Ooh, baby, no, backing off now. Orndorff not wanting to have his hair mussed.
Doesn't like that at all. Salvatore Bellomo with a European style. He can pull anything out of his box of wrestling tricks at any given time. He's going to be a mess of confusion for Orndorff, I feel, even though Orndorff does certainly have the strength.
Lighted luck now by Salvatore Bellomo, really pouring it on. Orndorff trying to find the escape. Whipped in a rope. Shoulder block. Goes Orndorff. Almost interrupts again. Drop toe hold. Look out quick.
Oh, he missed it.
And Salvadori quick to pick up with the hammerlock.
Orndorff too quick for his own good. And Belomo driving a hammerlock up.
An unusual mistake for a man of Orndorff's caliber. Very unusual mistake.
All right, we see now Salvatore Belomo locking up with the arm.
Is that arm well locked up? Going into a tough wrist lock. I'm not sure who has the advantage here, Vince.
We know now. With a knee there. Look at Belomo. He is really taking the punishment from Orndorff. Head first to the buckle. Belomo whipped out. No, nice reversal. Look at that. And Orndorff slowly slides to the outside, and he is hurt. Make no mistake about it. Tony Garea, when you take a feel like that, it's going to hurt.
Oh, it was a beautifully timed feel by Salvatore Belomo, and Orndorff hurt his back pretty bad there. You can see he's out there holding his back. He landed square on his back, and this was about the best move I think Orndorff could make under this situation. He's got out there, and he's rested, and he's getting in when he's ready, and he looks like he's ready now.
Belomo coming right in on Belomo, wrecking a face foul. Through the rope! Oh, my goodness! Orndorff coming out right after him. Orndorff, what's he have? Oh, no. What does he have in his hand? Oh, my. Busted him wide open. Oh, what a kick. Paul Orndorff. This Medicare warrior. Back to the ring now. Back. Here he comes again. Belomo scooped up.
Down on the cement floor again.
Incredible maneuver by Paul Orndorff.
Salvatore Belomo has got to have the wind completely knocked out of him at this point of the match. And here comes Orndorff again.
Orndorff steps in the ring just long enough to step back out again and deliver more damage. Belomo, oh my. Back in. He'll be right back out. Rich Topolomo finally back on his feet, gallantly, I might add. Coming back into the ring. Orndorff now. With Belomo sets him up. Back body drop.
It's completely knocked the wind out of Salvatore Belomo, and he's in a lot of trouble right now.
Here at Orndorff. Look at the arrogance of this man. He sent this victory. Drives the elbow.
No mercy at all from Paul Orndorff.
Absolutely not. Paul Orndorff trying to go for the kill now. What a drop kick. Down goes Belomo. Up high, off the rope, driving the knee. Tries it again down into the chest area this time. Orndorff certainly risking disqualification.
Salvatore Belomo's got to be in a lot of pain right now.
Hook up Orndorff with a kick that'll knock Belomo silly. Head first down to the apron.
This is a vicious, vicious wrestler, this Paul Orndorff. He wants to go to the top no matter what. But Salvatore Belomo making a little comeback there. Stopped by Paul Orndorff. Paul Orndorff has the sights of the Intercontinental Bout for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship in sight. He is going to stop at nothing to get there.
Orndorff taking punishment downstairs. Uh-oh. Orndorff behind below. Ooh, wow, what a suplex.
One, two, and so
on. Does not get him. Orndorff said no. Reversal. Oh, drop kick. Orndorff set up again. Belomo has it. Orndorff driving
right into the throat.
Cover, hooks the leg.
right into the throat of Salvatore Bologna.
There is a look at Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, an extraordinary physique. Yes, an extraordinary athlete. Make no mistake of it. We go back now to what we saw. Here, Bologna whipping Orndorff into the rope. Oh, look at this, going high. Orndorff deliberately drops Bologna right across the top rope. The top rope striking Bologna across the throat. From there, it's all Mr. Wonderful after that. Paul Orndorff won the victory.
So there you are. Mr. Wonderful himself, Paul Orndorff, getting the referee's verdict. Salvatore Bologna made an excellent account of himself, and I'm sure we're going to see a lot more from this Italian boy now that he's getting his baptism into this type of wrestling. Coming up, we have a very, very interesting update on the sergeant himself, Sergeant Slaughter. We also have some very great matches ready for you after these important messages.
This week's update concerns the one and the only Sergeant Slaughter. Sergeant Slaughter recently riding up in his camouflage limousine, I might add, all the way up to West Point, and began to inspect the troops. I must say, Sergeant Slaughter was received much like the conquering hero returning from the war. He is loved everywhere. Sergeant Slaughter is something else again. In a moment, we'll take you to videotape footage of Sergeant Slaughter around the Statue of Liberty. Whether it's in West Point or perhaps out by the Statue of Liberty, no matter where Sergeant Slaughter goes, you can bet he'll be doing one thing: spreading his brand of Americana, his brand of patriotism. And you best listen to Sergeant Slaughter. He might be inspecting the cadets in West Point, and again, he could be inspecting the local Boy Scout troop. Sergeant, one of a kind.
This contest, scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Entering the arena towards the ring from Kankakee, Illinois, weighing 244 pounds, Max Liu.
Max Liu.
And his opponent,
jungle drums,
huh? I think that's what it is. Jungle drums, indeed. All the natives are getting a little restless. All right, there, Freddy Bossy coming into view.
Being led down the aisle by his manager, the fashion plate, Freddy Blassie, attended by Friday, weighing 387 pounds, Kabola, the Ugandan giant.
Look at the size of this
man. Goodness. Wow. Kabola, the Ugandan giant. He is a monster. Incredible. Almost 400 pounds of him walking through this sea of people. And they make a big wide pass when this man, Kabola, comes through. There's Freddy Blassie leading Kabola to the square circle. Look at how big this man is, Tony Garea. He is huge.
He is unbelievable, Vince. I have never seen anything like this. Where does Freddy Blassie find these guys?
Well, Friday and Kabola testing things out, and there you see again, Kabola, he is huge.
The crowd here is in awe of it. Listen to them. They don't believe what they're seeing. I don't believe what I'm seeing.
Freddie Blassie with the Ugandan Giant. And you're right, Tony Garea. These fans are not too sure what they're looking at.
Look at the way that face is painted up, Vince. I guess that's some kind of a war paint, though.
Look at the shoulders on Kamala.
He is huge. He's big all over, from the ankles, the calves, thighs, the belly on him.
Friday, attending to the needs of the Ugandan Giant. Oh, my, are you kidding me? Ooh, wow. That's enough to scare an opponent into submission.
And that's the truth, then.
Freddie Blassie supervising the effort. Kamala. Kamala, what a chop. My goodness, another one. Max Blue having problems right away with the Ugandan Giant. Kamala with a right hand.
A relentless attack on Max Blue.
Oh, another chop.
It was to the throat area. That was a tough one, that one.
I believe a blatant chokehold, referee. No, has him way up, does Kamala. Unbelievable strength. Max Blue down to the canvas. Freddie Blassie, yelling for the referee. Kamala with a chop. Another chop. Oh, another one.
He hasn't given up from the time the bell is gone.
Kamala slapping that huge belly of his, and look at Max Blue bounce off of it. Hammering away. And again. Oh, what a chop.
Max Blue having no effect on Kamala.
Kamala talking about chopping away in another one. Look at that. Kamala almost hacking away at the neck.
Max Blue's in a lot of trouble. A whole heap of trouble. A punch to the midsection of Kamala. No effect.
Anyone would be in trouble. Kamala thus far, ooh, showing us very few actual wrestling holds. But I guess maybe he's having a good time in there thus far. He has not. Well, what's he doing now?
No. Looks like he was going to go up on that rope, but I don't think the rope would hold him.
Max Blue kicking in a midsection. And again on a receiving end, shot that time off the top of the head.
Put Max Blue right down on the canvas.
Ooh, another one. Ooh, wow. Kamala with a quick circle. Kamala right back all over Max Blue. Kamala hammering away on Max Blue. If Blue could get out of the ring, perhaps he'd have an opportunity to collect himself. Headbutt by Kamala.
That has to knock Max Blue's sense of that headbutt. 400 pounds.
Max Blue on his feet. Oh, ooh, what a shot. Kamala turns Max Blue over. Oh. Look out.
Oh, my goodness. No, not again, Vince. Not again, yes.
Oh.
Right into the small of the back.
Over on Max Blue. And Kamala. Victoria. I don't think Kamala wants to let his man up.
I don't think Max Brucker will be able to get up after that, Vincey. That's 400 pounds coming into the small of the back. Very dangerous for Max Brucker.
Kamala finally back up.
Uh-oh. What's he going to do?
Kamala, no. Oh, no. No. He's going to go up. That's 400 pounds. Friday and Blassie trying to get him down from there. They're trying to get him down. Look at Blassie. Blassie with a cane trying to get the huge Ugandan Giant off the top rope. back, take a look at what we saw just moments ago. Here now, the Ugandan giant Kamala with Max Wu. It was a lopsided matchup, that's for sure. An unbelievable splash. And here, oh my, forget about it.
The winner of this bout, Kamala, the Ugandan giant.
Goodness, look at this. Ugandan Kamala victorious. And is he ever impressive? My goodness. Huge. What a giant.
The Ugandan giant Kamala. What a strange and what a weird figure he creates. However, what a merciless and bone-crushing wrestler he is. I don't see many men capable of beating him. This man is a giant. But is he a giant at heart? Could he match himself against, for example, the WWF champion Hulk Hogan? Stay tuned and watch the wonderful ladies of wrestling, the Fabulous Moolah versus Wendy Richter.
The USA's professional wrestling special event. Everyone's favorite American, Sergeant Slaughter, takes on Iran's Iron Sheik in the final battle for U.S. supremacy. Then Washington's own Rocky Johnson looks to kill Scotland's Rowdy Roddy Piper. And Fiji's Jimmy Superfly Snuka has a score to settle with Tennessee tough guy Dr. D. USA flags down the superstars of wrestling.
Ladies and gentlemen, this title belt will be on the line at Madison Square Garden just moments from now. This lady to defend.
I'm ready. I'm ready.
Uh-oh, look at this hot cross, Gene.
Get ready.
Gene,
especially Cindy and yourself.
We are definitely ready for this fight. There is no question about it. Cindy and Wendy have been training now for about 2 months to prepare for this. And I don't think the Lou Albano, I don't care what he's got in store for, I don't think he's going to make it this time.
All
we
right,
are definitely
thank you very
ready.
Much. Some of the preliminaries. There's a good shot of Cindy Lauper. What an entertainer.
Well, this occasion looks in great shape.
Well, I'll tell you, whatever Cindy Lauper did for Wendy Richter, what a remarkable change in this very attractive young lady.
I'll tell you, Wendy is definitely ready.
Goulinov going out after Cindy. Holy mackerel.
I'll tell you something.
You know, I've got to wonder, Gorilla Monsoon, if somewhere in his vast audience of 22,000 plus, if Roddy Piper might be looking on.
I wouldn't be.
The question is, why is Albano still in this ring?
Hello, Albano. Always a state of chaos around this man.
For the last minute instructions here, well, if you don't have it all done by now, it's obviously too late. Kula now being checked by the referee, and Wendy just waiting patiently or impatiently, however you want to see it.
And you shut up, you punk! Dave Dog, you fabricated dog biscuit!
Please, gentlemen.
You prefabricated dog biscuit!
Let's let the action speak for itself.
All right, Ola.
Gotta assume the outside factors will be left outside.
There goes the bell, and we're underway.
We're off and running. Ola.
Ola starts out with an arm drag. And a favors return by Wendy.
Boy, Wendy Richter just looks superb. Dave Wolf, by the way, manager for Cindy Lauper, is at ringside with us.
And boy, is he excited.
I want to ask you a question, Dave. Who is the manager of Cindy Lauper?
I think we've gone over this about a million times. Lou never was her manager and never had anything to do with her career.
Boy, she uses that hair. Come on, ref. Please, give me a break.
Right hand sends Richter down to the canvas.
Flip into the ropes.
Look out. Flip. Monkey flip. Ola down for the cover. No, she won't get it. Kicked out twice. Handful of hair picks her up again.
I think Lou Albano's girlfriend has showed up ringside.
Wendy into the ropes again. No. Yes, another backdrop. Down for another cover. No, Wendy's got that left hand out of there. Now Ola pulled her up.
For what?
I don't know.
She had an opportunity, certainly, for the pin there, but Ola goes to the hair. And pulls Wendy Richter up. And finally, manages a full Nelson. Got the Lou Albano up on a ring apron. In the meantime,
Ola. Up where he doesn't belong. And Wendy now comes up. Cindy goes. Takes the screen. And he didn't connect with anything.
He didn't at all. What? Somewhat bewildered by Albano's athletic prowess, because it certainly is not being demonstrated at this time.
Well, Wendy had enough left to just pull out of the reach of Captain Lou Albano, and thank God for that.
We have got action. In front of a capacity crowd. One, two, four.
broken loose here in the garden.
Total chaos. Total chaos.
Look at the hug by Cyndi Lauper as she goes on.
I cannot believe it.
Congratulating Wendy
Richter. We have a new ladies champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. Wendy Richter. Guided to that title by Cyndi Lauper. Oh, my. This place has just exploded.
History has been made as the referee now raises the hand of Wendy Richter, and we have a new World Women's Heavyweight Champion. Unbelievable.
It's got to be one of the most sensational matches I have ever seen. Let's take a look at the replay right now. Here it is in slow motion. Gorilla Monsoon, I want to bring you down because I want you to take a look at some of the action as we see it right now.
Look at this. It was a double pin. Both shoulders were down, Gene. Now look at this. Just as the three count comes down, look at Wendy. Raise that right shoulder. Moolah's shoulders were down on the mat. What a call.
I've seen many, many matches. The fabulous Moolah and Richter certainly got into it there. There was absolutely no give between either of them. And as for what happened at the end there, well, Moolah really has only herself to blame. She placed herself in a position that she could not escape from. However, it could have gone in Moolah's direction, but it didn't. And now we have a new ladies' world champion, Wendy Richter, the Texas Cowgirl. We're now going to take you to Piper's Pit. And Piper, like he always is very controversial. But before we take you there, let me remind you, Piper's views are certainly not ours, and they're certainly not those of the USA Network. So having told you that, be prepared, because Piper will spring anything on you anytime he wishes. This particular pit is most interesting, and I'm sure you will get as much out of it as I intend to.
Hot rod here. Piper's Pit. This week, like I said to you, first of all, the champion, who now happens to be Wendy Richter, who has taken the world female heavyweight championship from the great Moolah, who is sitting in all her splendor. Now, I want to show you a clip of what Wendy and the celebration party later, and then, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you the difference between you and I. I'm going to show you exactly why I'm Roddy Piper and you're not. I want you to take a look at Wendy Richter in all her splendor and as happy as she can be. And then I will show you the truth, brother.
Cyndi Lauper, I'll tell you what. You know about hits. And tell me about this lady to your immediate left. Wendy Richter, the new lady champion, huh?
She's a smash. She's the champ. She's exotic looking. She's strong. She has new ideas, new purpose, and new meaning. And she's going to give a jolt to women's wrestling like never before.
Right.
And
all
I'm
right.
So proud of her, Gene.
I know you are.
You think you're so smart, huh? You see, I'm going to show you why I'm Roddy Piper and you're not. Next week on the pit, man, I'm going to have the whole collage for you. I'm going to have Wendy Richter. I'm going to have what happened. And I'm going to show you she didn't win nothing. And I'm going to point it out and I'm going to get the decision reversed. She did nothing. You want to see someone bust someone's bubble, brother? Huh? Just when you think you got all the answers, RP changes the question. You want to see a little girl break down and cry? Huh? You just come back next week, and old RP here, he'll show you exactly why.
What did I tell you about Piper? Nobody can ever predict what he's going to say now, next week, or next year. We're going to take you to something that was most interesting now. We're going to take you to the victory celebrations that were held after Wendy Richter won the ladies' world title. Gene Oakland was there. Many of the wrestlers were there. Unfortunately, I wasn't there. There were sporting personalities from all walks of life. I'm sure you'll enjoy it as much as I will.
If I may prevail upon you, ladies and gentlemen, present for the victory celebration tonight here on the Big Apple, World's Heavyweight Champion Hulk Hogan. Hulk, I don't want to take you away from from the food and all of the guests here, but I'm very, very curious your thoughts on the big victory tonight for Wendy Richter under the direction of Cyndi Lauper over Moolah.
You know what, me, Gene? I was very glad to see it happen, man, because I was worried about it. Moolah has reigned so long, man. I was worried about it, but the thing is, this is a new era, man. Hulkamania is running wild, and now we've got a new women's heavyweight champion. Wendy Richter is prime, brother. She's like a racehorse. Did you see the bias? Did you see the stride? The striations on the girl's body, man. She was training night and day like the Hulkster, Daddy, and that fat Moolah was sitting on 48th and Vine eating hot dogs, man. There's nothing to talk about, me, Gene. It was a clear-cut victory. The girl was in shape, brother. She outsmarted the old hag, and that's the way it's going to stay. She went down. That's right, brother. But the thing is, Mean Gene, a lot of people are going to have to put up with it because Wendy Richter and Hulk Hogan are going to be around for a long time, Daddy.
That must have been a wonderful, wonderful moment for the new ladies' world champion. She certainly deserves it. She's a lovely girl, but apart from that, she's a wonderful wrestler. I think she's going to hold that title for a long, long time. However, we have more wonderful moments coming up with a man of a thousand masks. I think that's what it is in Spanish, Mills Mascaris. And what a fantastic belt this is going to be.
The new edition of the official World Wrestling Federation magazine is now on sale at your local newsstand. Read about the rocking battle that continues between Cyndi Lauper and Captain Louis Albano. Tito Santana's helping hand. It was party time back when Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch won the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. West Point guest Sergeant Slaughter. Andre and the Hulkster join other celebrities, all saluting physical fitness. And the Superfly hot on the trail of Rowdy Roddy Piper. It's all on sale right now. The official World Wrestling Federation magazine.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the ring at this time, hailing from parts unknown, weighing 287 pounds, Moondog Fox.
Oh, my.
And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Mexico City, Mexico, weighing 235 pounds, the man of a thousand masks, Mil Mascara.
Tremendous ovation for Mil Mascara. Did he ever rip off the outside mask? And Mascara now preparing for action against Moondog Spot. But, of course, having a rather decided weight advantage, and perhaps more than that, Tony Garea, with that rather unusual bone, I guess that's a good luck charm. From time to time, that has been used in a match.
It certainly has been, and I think it's about time that something like this should be barred from ringside. Here it is, hanging up there on the post. Not about to stop.
All right, now, Moondog Spot, with Mascaris against the rope. Doubtful we'll see a clean break. Mascaris being set up to the rope. Gets him up. Nice maneuver by Moondog Spot. Mil Mascaris being set. No, there we go. Reversal. Oh! Moondog Spot, look at this maneuver. Yes, sir. Up again. Look at that. That is classic Mil Mascaris. No one in professional wrestling today performs quite like that, Tony.
Nobody at all, but nothing like Mil Mascaris. A man with a thousand masks and a man with a thousand moves. He's got moves that are unbelievable. There's a nice drop toe hold. Down, thrust up the leg.
And now Mascaris applying a little more pressure. Oh, wait a minute. I think he's fighting. Moondog Spot. Ooh, he goes downstairs with a right hand. Moondog Spot with a hard right. Moondog Spot now setting up Mascaris. No out front. Mascaris, nice reversal. Ooh, out and over. And Moondog Spot appears to be a little befuddled, Tony.
Well, Mascaris is very experienced, and he's just outmaneuvering Spot. Moondog Spot, he does have the weight advantage, but with Mascaris, he's about 20 pounds lighter, and he can definitely move a lot quicker than Moondog Spot.
Bit of a test of strength there. Mascaris, of course, is exhibited by that display. No slouch in the strength department either.
Mascaris got a beautiful physique on him, and he didn't get that sitting in front of a television screen drinking beer, that's for sure.
Oh, my! Picked him over to Sastry. Beautiful maneuver.
This is the Mexican style that Mil Mascaras has, and he's combined it with the American style, and it's turned out very well for him thus far, then.
Rather unique leg scissor there. Head scissor is now. Referee asked for the clean break. Noondog Fox backing Mil Mascaras in the corner now. Mascaras, look at that, very quickly going underneath the arm, and Moondog Spot is really now, I think, beginning to lose it.
Yes, Mascaras is antagonizing him a little bit with his moves, and Spot is losing control. It's a bad move for him.
Yeah, Pacquiao enjoying this matchup. Thus far, pretty much, if anyone's guessed, he'll come out on top, although Mascaras has the class, and as it always means, he'll be the victor. They're pulling the laces from the mask, I believe.
Yes, Vince, when you got two men with the caliber of Moondog Spot and Mil Mascaras in the ring, it can go either way. At any time, any man can win this match. It's not over until the referee says so.
Oh, and Moondog Spot was appeared, at least from our vantage point, to be setting up Mascaras for a right hand. Off the rope now. Nice shoulder block by Moondog Spot. Heading that way again. Over Mascaras. Right back down. Oh, my, what a beautiful maneuver. Flying tackle by Mil Mascaras. Mascaras cat-like now.
He's waiting. He's waiting to pounce. I'm not sure what he's waiting for.
Drop kick. Down goes Moondog Spot. Mascaras, look at that.
Beautiful. Super.
Yes, that was nicely done. We get, no, only one. Ooh, my. Moondog Spot comes up swinging. Moondog Spot hammering to the back of the head. Mascaras down on one knee now. And jamming, perhaps the thumb, into the throat of Mil Mascaras.
That's going to put Mascaras out of commission for a little while there. He's got to take a little time now to regain composure. But Moondog Spot is definitely ahead at this point, then.
So now becomes more of a brawling type matchup, something that Moondog Spot would excel at. Elbow to the back of the neck, and Mascaras, oh, look at this! Mascaras again! Mascaras hammering away on Moondog. Okay! Mascaras trying to set up the Moondog. Off the rope, another flying tackle.
Very effective, very effective.
Hammers him. He gets almost two. So thus far, Mascaras unable to put away Moondog Spot. Knee lift and an elbow to the back of the head at the same time. Mascaras dazed. Mascaras out in front. Nice reversal. Moondog Spot comes off. Back body drop. Mascaras going up. Mil Mascaras waiting for Moondog Spot. Moondog Spot turns around. Mascaras with a lead. One, two, right down the
well, that was beautifully executed by Mascaras. That's a beautiful move indeed.
Mil Mascaras on his way back through the capacity crowd. What a tremendous victory. My goodness, what a great one. Mil Mascaras comes up with the victory, and let's go back. Moondog Spot. And Mascaras gets the Duke. Mil Mascaras, a tremendous maneuver here. And Tony, as we said it before, few wrestlers, if anyone, can move quite like Mil Mascaras.
Mil Mascaras has all the moves. He has everything in wrestling that can be done. I'm sure Mil Mascaras has done. A fantastic scientific wrestler. And he's a very, very popular wrestler all over the world also.
Mascaras with that unusual mask on. And first wearing two masks into the ring. The mask itself is quite a psychological maneuver. Mil Mascaras using both psychological tactics as well as the physical ones to gain a victory here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Mascaras will be a force to contend with, no doubt of it.
Mills Mascaris, what a pleasing style that wrestler has. I'm sure we'll be seeing a lot more of him. The Moondogs, well, what can you say about the Moondogs? Except that they are vicious, vicious wrestlers. We would like to hear your comments, and we would like to hear your questions. Please write to us at this address that you'll see now on the screen in front of you.
Explosive action. USA has packed your Tuesday nights with the superstars of wrestling. It's Tuesday Night Titans Wrestling TNT. Featuring the heroes. The villains. The glamour, the glory, Tuesday Night Titans Wrestling TNT. Every Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, only on USA. It's dynamite.
Once again, All American Wrestling presented a wonderful program. We all here in the control room had a good time watching this. How about those ladies? Weren't they just fantastic? How about Mr. Orndorff? Or should I say Paul Orndorff, Mr. Wonderful? He too is pushing for a title very, very strongly. And then, of course, there was Kamala. What could be said about Kamala except that he's a giant, a Ugandan giant? And we're going to definitely have him back on the program. I'm sure we're going to get lots of letters about him. And now let me tell you about our program for next week. Because we are going to be even better next week than we were this week. We have Tito Santana, the Intercontinental Champion, and he will be pitting his skills against that rugged cowboy, Cowboy Bob Orton. That in itself is a fantastic match, but we have Ken Patera and other people on this same program. Be with us next week, same time.
Week on Tuesday Night Titans Wrestling TNT. Learn the Mexican hat dance with Intercontinental Champion Tito Santana and meet Kamala, the meanest Ugandan since Idi Amin. Plus more fireworks with host Vince McMahon and Lord Alfred Hayes on Tuesday Night Titans at 8 p.m. Eastern. Now stay tuned for Two-Fisted Action on Kung Fu Theater next on USA.
Edition of All American Wrestling. I'm Lord Alfred Hayes, standing in for your usual host, Vince McMahon. I would like to tell you something about our program this week, but you have just been watching a part of our feature match with the Fabulous Moolah against Wendy Richter. Be sure you don't miss this match. We're going to show it in its entirety, and what a humdinger it was as well. Apart from that match, we have the most charismatic masked wrestler here, Mills Mascaris. Mills Mascaris is going to hold you absolutely spellbound in your seats. And then we have a very, very important match, a most intriguing and interesting match with Mr. Wonderful himself, Paul Orndorff, and he is going against the Italian Salvatore Bellomo. And as if that isn't enough, we're still going to have more for you, including Cowboy Bob Orton. Be sure you stay with us.
World Wrestling Federation continues on tour on Wednesday night, August 1 in Ogdensburg, New York, a special World Wrestling Federation fundraiser. Also in Utica, New York, at the War Memorial Auditorium on Wednesday night, August 1. Plus, a special World Wrestling Federation extravaganza in Binghamton, New York, on Thursday night, August the 2nd, as well as Watertown, New York, also Thursday night, August 2. Baltimore, Maryland, the setting, Friday night, August 3 at the Baltimore Civic Center for a World Wrestling Federation spectacular. Plus, Saturday night, August 4, Boston, the Boston Garden, the setting for an unbelievable spectacular. Philadelphia, the Philadelphia Spectrum. Saturday night, August 4, World Wrestling Federation action headed your way. Continuing on into New Haven, Connecticut on Sunday night, August 5 at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Notwithstanding, Richmond, Virginia on Tuesday night, August 7, and Winston-Salem, North Carolina, Wednesday night, August 8. Tremendous World Wrestling Federation spectaculars headed your way.
His opponent, now entering the ring area, from Florida, weighing 262 pounds, Paul, Mr. Wonderful Orndorff.
Well, indeed, Mr. Wonderful, to make his way to the ring, and right away, this capacity crowd on his case. Many of them shouting, Paula. A phrase, Tony Garea, that Mr. Orndorff does not like at all.
He gets furiated when he sees those signs up and when he hears those people yelling out Paula. And there's going to be a lot of Paula here this week and a lot of signs up.
Well, the roar of the crowd can mean only one thing. Mr. Orndorff is making his way, yes. There, this capacity crowd clearing the path for Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Look at him. You talk about arrogance. This man exudes arrogance.
And listen to that crowd. Paula, Paula.
Yes, indeed. Mr. Orndorff's arrogance is certainly not appreciated by this capacity crowd. Preparing for the matchup with Mr. Wonderful.
Also, Paul Orndorff, a great all-round athlete. College football player, just fantastic athlete. And look at the body on him.
Yes, indeed.
You don't get that drinking beer and eating crackers watching TV. You have to be in the gym working out and sweating.
Orndorff now, I would suspect, would have problems, maybe a lot of problems, in figuring out the skills of Salvatore Bellomo, who has a very European type tactic now locked up. Orndorff, obviously the stronger of the two. It may not mean anything. Ooh, baby, no, backing off now. Orndorff not wanting to have his hair mussed.
Doesn't like that at all. Salvatore Bellomo with a European style. He can pull anything out of his box of wrestling tricks at any given time. He's going to be a mess of confusion for Orndorff, I feel, even though Orndorff does certainly have the strength.
Five in luck now by Salvatore Bellomo, really pouring it on. Orndorff trying to find the escape. Whipped in a rope. Shoulder block. Goes Orndorff. Bellomo's in a rope again. Drop toe hold. Look how quick. Oh, he missed it.
And Salvatore quick to pick up with the hammerlock.
Orndorff too quick for his own good. And Bellomo driving a hammerlock up.
An unusual mistake for a man of Orndorff's caliber. Very unusual mistake.
All right, we see now Salvatore.